This is the third in a series of screencasts about cylinders in cross flow. We're using different correlations to find our Nusselt number, which gives us our convective heat coefficient, H, and eventually, given our Q prime, which is watts per meter, what we want from this correlation is to find our surface temperature. So above we have a correlation, probably the most complicated of the ones that we would see, called the Churchill-Bernstein. Let's take a look at our different properties and show you how to figure out the surface temperature. So flowing over the cylinder, we have air in cross flow that has a velocity of 75 meters per second, and that air is at a bulk temperature of 25 degrees C. The diameter of our rod is 0.4 times 10 to the minus 3 meters, and this heat transfer per unit length is equal to 25 watts per meter. In order to solve for our Nusselt number, if you notice, we're going to need a Prandtl number and we're going to need to calculate a Reynolds number. So in order to do both of those things, we're going to have to look up properties of air. And so we look everything up at a film temperature, which is just the average of our T infinity plus our surface temperature. And in this case, we don't know our surface temperature, so we're going to guess that it's around 40 degrees C and look it up under that assumption. We need the kinematic viscosity. We're also going to need the thermal conductivity of the fluid, because you'll notice if you take a look back here, we need it when we're taking the Nusselt number and turning it into our convective heat transfer coefficient. And we can look up our Prandtl number. Prandtl number is dimensionless. So let's start by calculating our Reynolds number. So the Reynolds number is equal to the velocity times the diameter divided by that kinematic viscosity. So that's 1,887. And now let's do the tedious job of putting our Reynolds number and our Prandtl number into the above equation. The hardest thing about this actually is getting all of your exponents correct, as well as putting the parentheses in the right place. One of the things that I recommend is to calculate this term by term. And so if you did everything correctly, you end up with a Nusselt number equal to 22.1. Again, the Nusselt number is dimensionless. And one of the things I do want to mention, note that there's that bar over the Nusselt number. That means that we're looking for an average Nusselt number and eventually an average convective heat transfer coefficient. So now let's go ahead and solve. And by the way, the heat transfer coefficient is not a dimensionless number. And in fact, what we get for our H bar is 1,458 watts per meter squared Kelvin. Let's go back here, because if you remember, what we're trying to find is this surface temperature here. So let's rearrange that particular equation so that we can solve for that surface temperature. We find that TS is equal to our Q prime divided by H bar times pi times D plus T infinity. And so our surface temperature is equal to 39 degrees C, very close to what we guessed for our film temperature.